फ्रेंड्स दिस इज फोर्थ टॉपिक थर्मोडायनामिक्स फ्रॉम एचएससी बोर्ड फिजिक्स. इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज रिवर्सिबल प्रोसेस, व्हाट आर इरिवर्सिबल प्रोसेसेस. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस, व्हाट इज आइसोबारिक प्रोसेस, व्हाट इज आइसोकोरिक प्रोसेस. ओके सो वी विल स्टार्ट विथ व्हाट इज आइसोथर्मल प्रोसेस एंड थर्मोडायनामिक्स ऑफ isothermal process. The process that takes place, the suppose there is change in pressure, there is change in volume, so if this process takes place at constant temperature, it is known as isothermal process. Okay, so isothermal process is constant temperature process. Isothermal process is constant temperature process. Okay, so for the temperature to be constant, the system must be in thermal in thermal contact with the surrounding or environment. The system must exchange the heat to the surrounding. That means there must be heat given to the surrounding or from surrounding to the system so that thermal equilibrium is reached. The process that takes place at constant temperature is known as isothermal process. Okay, for example, melting of ice is isothermal process because it takes place at constant temperature. Now we will see what is thermodynamics of isothermal process. Okay, so we know that statement of Boyle's law, that is pressure is inversely proportional to volume at constant temperature. Okay, so pressure is inversely proportional to volume at constant temperature. That means PV is equal to constant. Okay, suppose PI and VI are pressure and volume at initial state. PF and VF are pressure and volume at final state. We will consider some change. Suppose the change in volume is taking place from VI to VF. Okay, so for this expansion, we will consider infinitesimal change. Work done for infinitesimal change, dW is equal to P into dV. So work done, total work done from the change in volume from VI to VF will be W is equal to integration of dW, integration of all such work done from VI to VF. Okay, so W is equal to integration of PdV, volume changes from VI to VF. So we know that PV is equal to nRT. T is equal to nRT by V. So I will substitute here. So W is equal to integration of nRT by V and dV. So I will take nRT outside the integration sign, therefore it will be W is equal to nRT integration of dV by V, volume changes from VI to VF. Now we know that integration of 1 upon V is log V. I will write it as W is equal to nRT ln of, that is final volume is VF, initial volume is VI, subtraction of final value minus initial value. So this is value for work done for the isothermal change from volume VI to VF. Now, according to first law of thermodynamics, we know that dQ is equal to dU plus dW. So, for isothermal change, we know that temperature is constant. Temperature is constant, that means delta T is equal to 0. As delta T is equal to 0, change in internal energy is also 0. Therefore, dQ is equal to dW, or we can say Q is equal to W. Okay. So, when gas expands, the work done is positive work done. Heat is absorbed by the system. So, when the gas is compressed, work done is negative. Energy is released. Heat energy is released. Okay. So, the PV diagram for the isothermal change, that means the change that is taking place at constant temperature, is known as isotherm. Okay, so this is pressure axis, this is volume axis. Pressure initially is PI, finally it is PF. Initially volume is VI, volume is VF here. As pressure decreases, volume increases. The isotherm is like this. A is initial state, B is final state. So this is isotherm. Okay, so this is isothermal process. We have seen isothermal process. Now we are going to see isobaric process. The process that takes place at constant pressure is known as isobaric process. Okay, so for isobaric process, pressure is constant. Pressure is constant, that means change in pressure is not there. So change in pressure is zero for isobaric process. Okay, but here volume is not constant. Volume is not constant, that means delta V is there. It is not zero. So temperature is also not constant. Temperature is also not a constant. Okay, for isobaric process. So temperature is not constant, that means delta T is not equal to zero, or change in internal energy is also there. There is value for Q. They are not zero. Any of these quantities, change in volume, change in temperature, change in internal energy must be there, is there. And Q, these values are not zeros. Okay, the PV diagram for isobaric process, suppose this is pressure axis, this is volume axis, pressure is constant, so it is parallel to volume axis as pressure is constant. So different lines, curves on the maps, they are given by meteorology department. They are all isobars. Okay, so this is isobaric process. Now we are going to see what is thermodynamics of isobaric process. Okay, so we consider the change in volume here. So if VI and TI are the volume and temperature at initial state, if VF and TF are the volume and temperature at final state, so work done dW or W, we can say it is equal to P into dV. It is equal to P into VF minus VI. Again, we know that PV is equal to nRT. So instead of P, if we can substitute, then it will be nRTF minus TI. Okay, W is equal to nRTF minus TI. So this is value for W. Now we know that change in internal energy, delta U is equal to nCV delta T. Change in internal energy, delta U, it is equal to nCV delta T, where CV is specific heat at constant volume. So it is nothing but nCV TF minus TI. Okay, so according to first law of thermodynamics, dQ is equal to dU plus dW, or we can say dU, that is delta U, it is nCV TF minus TI, and this dW, that is W, it is equal to nR TF minus TI. Okay, so if I take common nCV plus nR, then it is TF minus TI. See here, dQ is equal to dU plus dW, or we can say Q is equal to delta U plus W. So delta U here is nCV delta T, that is nCV TF minus TI. W here is nR TF minus TI. So if I take n common, n bracket CV plus R into TF minus TI. So it is CV plus R. It is n into CP TF minus TI. Okay. So I will write here, see here, CP, CV plus R is CP. CP is specific heat at constant pressure. We know the Mayer's relation, CP minus CV is equal to capital R. Okay. Therefore, Q is equal to nCP, n into CP, this TF minus TI is equal to delta T. So this is value for Q. Q is equal to nCP delta T.